Hi. My name is Lyra Scout, and this is a brief Wikivids video about Carl Friedrich Gauss. Johann Carl Friedrich Gauss, April 30, 1777 to February 23, 1855, was a German mathematician who contributed significantly to many fields, including number theory, algebra, statistics, analysis, differential geometry, geodesy, geophysics, mechanics, electrostatics, magnetic fields, astronomy, matrix theory, and optics. Sometimes referred to as the princeps mathematicorum, the foremost of mathematicians, and the greatest mathematician since antiquity, Gauss had an exceptional influence in many fields of mathematics and science, and is ranked as one of history's most influential mathematicians. He was an ardent perfectionist and a hard worker. Gauss was never a prolific writer, refusing to publish work that he did not consider to be complete and above criticism. This was in keeping with his personal motto Pacis sed matura, few, but ripe. His personal diaries indicate that he had made several important mathematical discoveries years or decades before his contemporaries published them. Mathematical historian Eric Temple Bell said that if Gauss had published all of his discoveries in a timely manner, he would have advanced mathematics by 50 years. In his 1799 doctorate in absentia, Gauss proved the fundamental theorem of algebra, which states that every non-constant single-variable polynomial with complex coefficients has at least one complex root. In astronomy, after 3 months of intense work, Gauss predicted a position for the dwarf planet Ceres in December 1801, just about a year after its first sighting, which turned out to be accurate within a half degree when it was rediscovered by Franz Xaver von Zach on 31st of December at Gotha, and one day later by Heinrich Albers in Bremen. Gauss's method involved determining a conic section in space, given one focus, the Sun, and the conic's intersection with three given lines, lines of sight from the Earth, which is itself moving in an elliptical orbit, and given the time it takes the planet to traverse the arcs determined by these lines. One of the methods Gauss developed when solving this problem was the fast Fourier transform, which was not discovered by Fourier himself until 6 years later. In 1809 Gauss published his monograph Theoria Modus Corporum Coelestium in Sectionibus Conicis Solum Ambientium, where among other things he introduces several important statistical concepts, such as the method of least squares, the method of maximum likelihood, and the normal distribution. In 1818 Gauss carried out a geodetic survey of the Kingdom of Hanover, linking up with previous Danish surveys. To aid the survey, Gauss invented the heliotrope, an instrument that uses a mirror to reflect sunlight over great distances for the purpose of measuring positions. The geodetic survey fueled Gauss's interest in differential geometry and topology, fields of mathematics dealing with curves and surfaces. Among other things, he came up with the notion of Gaussian curvature. This led in 1828 to an important theorem, the theorem egregium, remarkable theorem, establishing an important property of the notion of curvature. Informally, the theorem says that the curvature of a surface can be determined entirely by measuring angles and distances on the surface. Gauss also claimed to have discovered the possibility of non-Euclidean geometries but never published it. This discovery was a major paradigm shift in mathematics, as it freed mathematicians from the mistaken belief that Euclid's axioms were the only way to make geometry consistent and non-contradictory. Research on these geometries led to, among other things, Einstein's theory of general relativity, which describes the universe as non-Euclidean. Gauss died in Göttingen on February 23, 1855, where he is interred in the Albany Cemetery. Two individuals gave eulogies at his funeral: Gauss's son-in-law Heinrich Abelard and Wolfgang Sartorius von Waltershausen, who was Gauss's close friend and biographer. His brain was preserved and was studied by Rudolf Wagner, who found its mass to be slightly above average. Highly developed convolutions were also found, which in the early 20th century were believed to be the explanation of his genius. Well, my friends, I hope you've enjoyed this brief video about Carl Friedrich Gauss. Until next time, this has been Lyra Scout for Wikivids.